Hey there. You must be here for the piercing consultation. Great, nice to meet you. I'm Cece, and if you do choose to go ahead with a piercing, then I'll be doing it for you. So, how can I help you today? Do you have any idea at all what you're looking for? So you're not really too sure at all. You just know you want a piercing. Okay. Well, obviously, you can have piercings pretty much anywhere on your body. I would say for a first piercing, especially as you're not aware of your pain threshold, I would say maybe opt for something more basic, like an ear piercing. I know you see all these pictures online of all these really cool piercings. I know. Okay, so you quite wanted a piercing just here? Okay. I think the best thing to do is to show you the different types of ear piercings. Are you aware of any of the names or anything? No. Okay, fab. I like to show this to anyone who isn't too sure. So, okay, so here we have the most popular piercings for the ear. Okay, so to start with, we have the rook. Can you just see that? So that is just literally just inside there. Yes, just be there. It's quite a nice little look, and once you have a couple down here and maybe one up here, it's quite a nice vibe. Then you have the forward helix. Okay, so just through there. Then you have the Daith piercing, which is just there. And then you have the tragus, which has become very popular. It's literally just that bit just there. Yep, just there. Then on literally just like the opposite to there, just sort of parallel, you have the antitragus. Then, of course, you've got your standard lobe, which is just what I've got in at the moment. Just down here, just about here, you have your transverse lobe. And then moving on, if you had a long bar going through here, that's an industrial piercing. Okay, so all the way down here. Very, very popular is the helix, which is just going to be around the outside there. On the inside, just here, following down from the rook, you have the snug. And then you have the orbital, which can go around here. Just inside here, you have the inner conch and the outer conch, which is just about here. And then you have the upper lobe, which is just about here. Okay. So, they are your options. What takes your fancy? I know it can be quite difficult to start with. If I'm being completely honest, If you're not sure, I would say to just go with a really standard low piercing. I know it's a little bit boring. However, as I say, you can test out your pain threshold before you get the other ones done. As soon as you start to move up here, you go more into cartilage, it becomes more painful. Okay, this is going to be much, much quicker to heal. You're going to have less pain afterward as well. You will need to keep this one in though. We recommend 6 to 12 weeks. 12 weeks, ideally, to be honest. It's just basically so the hole can form properly. Otherwise, if you take it out too quickly, it could easily seal back up. It could lead to infection. It's just much, much safer to have a nice, well-kept earring in there for the 12 weeks. Okay? So, how does that sound? Yeah, I can show you some earrings that I've put in, of course. Now, normally we do recommend a silver or gold to be popped in, but of course you can choose more of a fashion stud. It's completely up to you. We do recommend more studs rather than dangly earrings, as it were. We can pop in a hoop, just a small one, but really I'd say go with a stud. Okay, so is there any particular style that you quite like? You quite like my one at the moment. Yeah, no. This one I definitely couldn't pop in for you to start with. It would have to be something smaller. Let me have a look. Okay. Are you into a little bit of bling at all? Anything with a bit of sparkle? Yeah. Perfect. Okay, so I could put in something like this for you. So this is just a little rose-coloured stud, and it's just quite a nice size if I put it up to my ear for you. Obviously, we have clean ones of these, but if you like, I can show you the more the sizing. So in the ear, it's gonna look around this size. Okay, just to give you an idea. Yeah. Okay, all right, we can carry on. Keeping with the bling theme, you can go for something a little bit bigger. So you can go for something more like this. Obviously, it's good to think about, your fashion style, what you tend to wear. That's why I kind of recommend going for something more basic, but it's completely up to you. These actually come in a little emerald green and also a nice deep purple. Okay. Now, if you wanted to go for something completely different, we have a nice 9-carat gold little rabbit here. So that will just go in the ear like that. So more subtle. I don't know if you're a gold or a silver or a rose gold wearer. You wear them all. Okay, great. Well, something like this can can be quite good, just because it's nice and small. You're less likely to be catching it when you do your hair, risk pulling it out and things like that. Let's see what else I've got for you. Along the lines of something blingy, I do actually have a little gold skull here, which is quite fun. It actually sits. I can pop this one in. So it actually sits just below the ear. So it's quite fun. You quite like that? Yeah, it's quite nice. Yeah, blingy. Who doesn't want a blingy skull? Alternatively, you can go for something like little pearl. You could have something like this, which again is quite nice. It's quite nice to go for something a bit more subtle, so that's an option for you. Yeah. No, I'll keep going through them, that's fine. Obviously, we do have, absolute basics. So you can have a little gold ball, silver, or rose gold. Let me see if I've got an example. So a little gold ball would look like this. And I'll just pop this in to show you just how, small it is. Okay, so that just looks like that. So very, very small. It's quite nice though in a way, because if you did decide to have like the second upper lobe done here, then it's nice that this is a bit smaller, or any other piercings around it. So you can have that in silver, and we also do the rose gold of that as well. And these are actually 18 karat. Yeah. So obviously you've got the price of the actual doing the piercing itself, and then the price of the earring. All right. So we do have just a basics range. Most of them are 9 karat or sterling silver. And then of course we do have more of the fashion pieces, which vary in price. Okay, so I can show you a few more. So we just have a little gold flower, which looks like this. It's quite sweet. I don't know what your style is. Is this what you tend to wear normally? Quite nice, cool, casual. Cool, casual with a little bit of bling. I like it. Okay. What else do we have? I do have a nice little simple diamante stud. Let me see if I can find that. Yeah, so this is really sweet. Again, I'll just pop this in for you, because sometimes when you haven't had them done before, you can just see how they sit, and sometimes seeing it on someone else's ear is better. So this just looks like that. And again, just really, really simple. I think when I first had mine done, I believe I had these in. So just nice and simple. That is another option. Yeah, you quite like that. Yeah, I think that's a good way to go. I'll just show you a couple more. So you can go for maybe something like this. So again, a little bit of bling for you. And it's just got this nice little coloured stone. It's quite sweet. Or you can go for something maybe in a silver. This is a little flower with a blue little gemstone in the middle. And these are sterling silver. Yeah? You decided? Perfect. Okay, what are we going for? The little diamondos. I think that's a good choice. Okay, great. So, now we've decided on that, we're definitely going to go with the standard lobe. Perfect. Okay, so now you've decided on what you'd like, I'll just talk you through the couple of different piercing processes, just so you're aware of them. So, lots of places offer mainly gun piercings. So these are super quick, and basically they will shoot the earring straight into your ear. So it's really, really fast. It's great for first time piercing because it is so quick. The only issue is that for me, I don't think it's the best way to do it because it doesn't push the skin all the way through and out. So when I first had mine done, when I was a lot younger, I don't know, maybe 10 or something like that, I had them done with a gun, and even still today I have this kind of hard lump in the piercing, and that's because the skin was never pushed through. So when I did get my own place to start doing piercings and tattoos and everything, I said that I wanted to follow the needle method. Now, this method is basically as it sounds. We take a sterilized needle suitable for the size hole that you're looking for in the earring, and then we simply sterilize the area, numb it if you know you would like us to, and then a needle is pierced through and then the earring is placed in. Okay, and that way when we push it through, we know that it's a nice clean hole. Okay, and you're not going to get that hard lumpiness. So the needle is the method that I'm going to be using on you today. All right, now how squeamish are you? Would you like the numbing gel? Just a little bit. Yeah, that's fine. That's okay. So what I'm going to do is I am just going to go and get a fresh pair of the earrings. You just sit there nice and relaxed, and then I'll come back and just clean your ears, sterilize the area, and then we will get those ears pierced. Okay. Okay, so let me pop some gloves on, health and safety. These are latex free, by the way, in case you are wondering. I know that some people do have latex allergies, so we like to use latex free here just to be safe. Okay, warm those up a little bit for you. Okay, so I've got a nice soft cotton pad here. And I've got some sterilizing lotion. So if you could just tuck your hair behind your ears, that's perfect. All right, let's get these ears nice and clean. Okay, they are nice and clean. No, that's great. And we're going just for a little bit of the numbing gel as well. Yeah, no problem. Just gonna wrap this in. Fingers just a little bit over the air, just that. Okay, perfect. So, what I like to say to my first time clients is either just to look away whilst I do one it and vice versa, or just to close your eyes or look straight ahead, whatever you prefer. It's going to be over before you know it, so quick, and then you're going to have lovely, nice earrings. Okay, so I'm going to do it on the count of three. All right, so I'm going to say one, two, three, and then you're going to have a lovely new piercing. All right, so just get my needle nice and sterile out the packet, and let's do this. Okay. One, two, three. Let's just get the earring in there. Perfect. One done. I know I went on the count of two. I know. That's my little trick. I apologize. How do you feel? Didn't even feel it. That's what I like to hear. All right, ready for the other one? Yeah. Okay. Let's do this then. Let's ready. One, two, three. Perfect. Let's get the earring just in there. Okay. You have lovely newly pierced ears. Do you want to have a look in the mirror? It's just there. Happy? Yeah, they look really nice. I think that was a good choice, it feels weird, doesn't it? It does feel weird. Just take a seat back down and just check the backs are on okay. How do they feel? Feel okay? Yeah. So included in your price today, I'm gonna give you some of this aftercare lotion. What I want you to do is just keep your ears nice and clean. Okay, instructions are on the lotion. Just use a little cotton pad, and just take daily care. Okay. Okay, and your ears should stay lovely and clean with no infections, and you shouldn't have any troubles. Okay, so let me just give this one to you. That is a new one. Take that with you. If you have any trouble at all, just come back and see us, all right? Or if you want some more, I know you'll get the fever and then you won't be able to stop. I know. Exactly. Well, I'm really pleased I could help you out today. Is there anything else I can do for you? Any other questions you'd like answered? Nope, you're all good. Great. Okay then. Well, just head up the counter, okay? They'll just finish things off for you. And yeah, I will. Well, hopefully, I won't be hearing from you with any troubles. But if I can help you with any extra piercings or tats, then let me know. All right. Go and show them off. All right. Bye. Bye.